Hello, I'm Forrest. Forrest Gump. Would you like a chocolate?
Oh, no, thank you.
My mama always said that life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. It's funny what a man remembers about his life. She wanted me to have the finest education.
Remember what I told you, Forrest? You are the same as everybody else. You were no different.
Your son is different, Mrs. Gump. He has an IQ of 75.
We are all different.
Oh, Clarissa, may I call you Clarissa? Let me show you something. This here is normal. And down here is your son. But don't you fret none. I'm sure we can come to some arrangement.
And that's when I met Jenny. She was my special friend. My only friend. We was together all the time, Jenny and me. We was like peas and carrots.
Run, Forrest, run!
You wouldn't believe me if I told you, but I could run like the wind blows. If I was going somewhere, I was running. They put me on a team called the All-America team.
Who the hell is that?
That's Forrest Gump, coach. A local idiot. But he sure runs fast.
Would you believe it? I gotta go to college too. And after only 5 years, I got a college degree. Mama was so proud. But then I joined the army.
Hello, I'm Forrest.
Nobody gives a shit who you are, this boy. You're in the army now, boy.
Yes, drill sergeant.
Gump, what's your sole purpose in this army?
Do whatever you tell me to do, drill sergeant.
God damn it, you're a genius. That's the most outstanding answer I've ever heard. You must have an IQ of 160. By Gump, you are gifted. Listen up, people. I want everybody's attention to assemble and disassemble their weapon. In the fastest possible time.
Yes, Drill Sergeant.
What you do is you just drag your net along the side of the boat. On a good day, you could catch 100 pounds of shrimp. Everything goes all right. 2 men shrimp in 10 hours a day minus what you send on the gas.
Don't drill, Sergeant!
Gump, why'd you put that weapon back together so quickly?
You told me to do drill, Sergeant!
Jesus Christ, this is a new company record. If it wasn't for such a waste of a fine enlisted man, I'd recommend you for an OCS. Someday you're going to be a general, Gump. Disassemble your armor, continue!
My mom was always telling me how miracles happen every day. Some people don't think so, but they do. I met Jenny after years apart, but she wasn't happy. But I knew I could make her happy. Just Jenny and me.
Do you ever dream, Forrest, about who you're gonna be? I'm gonna be a singer, with my guitar, my voice. Just me. Have you ever been with a girl before, Forrest?
I sat next to him in my home economics class all the time.
You're so sweet, Forrest.
You can come stay with me in Greenbow. I take good care of you.
I know you would, Forrest. Why are you always so good to me?
Because you are my girl, Jenny. I'm not a smart man, Jenny. But I know what love is. Will you marry me, Jenny? I'll make you a good husband.
You will, Forrest.
But you won't marry me.
No, Forrest. Okay.
You are sending me to Vietnam, Jenny.
Vietnam? Listen, you got a problem. ask you something, Forrest. If you ever in trouble, you don't try to be brave, okay? You just run, okay?
Okay, Jenny, I promise.
I do love you, Forrest, so you just run, okay?
Now, they told us that Vietnam was going to be different. And that's when I met Lieutenant Dan.
Do not salute me! There are snappers everywhere! Welcome to the 4th Platoon! You stick with me, you'll be alright. Where in the world are you guys from?
Alabama, sir.
You guys twins?
We are not related.
Right, listen up. There's two rules in the army. Number one, take good care of your feet. And number two, don't go doing something stupid like getting yourself killed or such like.
Lieutenant Dan sure knew his stuff. I felt real lucky he was my lieutenant. And as it turned out, I saved his life. Though he seemed real angry about it sometimes.
I told you to leave me out there. I didn't ask you to pull me out. And then they gave you the Congressional Medal of Honor. You?
Yes, they did, sir.
You, an imbecile. A moron. The Congressional Medal of Honor.
A nice shiny one.
Well, I've just got one thing to say about that. God bless America.
And just like that, my service in the United States Army was over. So I went home. I'm home, Mama.
I'm so happy to see you. I've missed you so much. We've had all sorts of visitors calling. I'm so proud of you, Forrest. You look good. Real good. But I'm tired now.
What's the matter, Mama?
I'm dying, Forrest.
Why are you dying, Mama?
It's my time. It's just my time. Oh, now, don't you be afraid, sweetheart. Death is just a part of life. It's something we're all destined to do. And I didn't know it, but I was destined to be your mama. And I did the best I could.
You did good, Mama.
Well, I happen to believe you make your own destiny. You have to do the best with what God gave you.
What's my destiny, Mama?
You're gonna have to figure that out for yourself, Forrest. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Mama always had a way of explaining things so I could understand them. And since I've been a war hero, a football star, a national celebrity, a shrimp boat captain, a college graduate, the city fathers of Greenbow, Alabama decided to get together and offer me a fine job.
Hello, Forrest. This is my son, Forrest. I called him after his dad.
His dad called Forrest.
Hello, Dad.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.